tomorrow is Bell Let's Talk Day, and this morning we are looking at mental health through the lens of parenthood. How to figure out if your child is just going through a phase or in real trouble. There is now a book to guide you through it. It's called Start Here, A Parent's Guide to Helping Children and Teens Through Mental Health Challenges. It's written by two psychiatrists who have a combined 6 decades worth of experience between them from the Hospital for Sick Children and the Center for Addiction and Mental Health. Dr. Pier Bryden and Dr. Peter Szatmari join us this morning. Thank you so much for being here.
You're welcome.
This book, I mean, I think whether you are concerned about your children or you are just a parent and you need some answers, this book is the guide I think we've all been looking for. You've got plenty of advice for different things that your kids could be going through, but one thing that you say first is don't look away. So Dr. Bryden, what does that mean?
I think many parents tell us they're quite intimidated about raising difficult topics, particularly with teenagers. You're worried about pushing them away. You're worried about putting dark thoughts into their heads. Or maybe you didn't have a lot of experience in your family raising those questions. So what we're trying to say is start early, talk to your kids about their mental health, how they're feeling, and make it clear that there's no judgment. You're there to help and you want to listen.
Dr. Szatmari, how do you know if it's a phase or if your child is in real trouble?
That's a really good question. There's a number of different things that we look at when we try and decide one way or the other. I think one important thing is if there's a big change in your child's behavior, and if there's a change in functioning, in particular, not doing well at school, withdrawing from friends, a lot of conflict with family, those sorts of things. So change in behavior and then a change in functioning as well. Two really important signs.
And how long are we talking? Because I know some of that can happen like over a week or months. Yeah. Is there a normal in this?
Well, no, there's no normal. And it sort of depends on what the problem is. But, you know, a month, 2 months is certainly time. If it lasts beyond that time period, then that's certainly a warning sign, a red flag to think.
Dr. Bryden, if you've made an appointment, what do you bring to that first visit?
So I always suggest it's helpful to bring copies that you can leave because we won't necessarily have time to read them in the appointment. But any recent report cards, if your child's ever had an educational assessment, if there were concerns about attention or learning disorders, it's really helpful to bring those things. I also suggest parents write their questions down because it can be a bit nerve-wracking, particularly if it's a first appointment, and that will help you remember the important key questions you wanted to make sure you covered.
Dr. Szatmari, for parents, when you see your child struggling, I mean, that takes a huge toll on you as a parent. You feel like a failure. You feel like you've done something wrong. So how do we also take care of ourselves while we're trying to care for our child?
It's a really important issue. A very important aspect is to work together as a team, you and your partner, to try and problem solve, think of this together, bring in your other social supports, talk to grandparents, brothers and sisters, what their experience like. And then I think it's really important to go to the family doctor and have a good relationship with your family doctor so that he or she can provide that support and guidance as to what to do at the very beginning.
I've read through the book, and the takeaway that I take from it is don't wait, don't be afraid to talk. And if you have a gut feeling something is wrong, act on it.
Parents know. They know their kids, and we have learned to listen to parents, and when they tell us there's a concern, we want to know about it and help.
Okay.
And I think one other thing is that there's so much more knowledge now, and we have so many more effective treatments than we did when I started out in practice, that it's really very encouraging that we need to get those therapies out there, people to access them and use them, because we've got them now, so let's use them.
Okay, doctors, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The book is called Start Here, A Parent's Guide to Helping Children and Teens Through Mental Health Challenges. Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this, be sure to subscribe here, or you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.